Thank you, Madam Speaker. I rise to ask question 100 of 2017 in my name to the Honourable Minister for Defence and National Security. Recent information and statistics maintained by the Fiji Police Force show fluctuations in overall crime cases. Can the Honourable Minister explain the recent trend in overall crime for the past 3 years? Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you. I give the floor to the Honourable Minister for Defence and National Security.
Madam Speaker, I'd like to thank the Honourable Howard Politini for his question. Also, I wish to affirm and support the media release put out by the Commissioner of Police on the 24th of January 2017 that the Fiji Police Force has recorded an overall reduction in the crime rate in 2016. In comparing the overall crime statistics in the five categories of overall offences, the following trend was recorded. The offences against the lawful authority, there was an increase of 27%. Against the person, 70 plus, it was increased of 75%. Offences against the crime decree, increase of 48%. While offences against public morality, a reduction of 61%. And offences against the property, reduction of 24%. Madam Speaker, while there is a fluctuation in overall crimes, the statistics indicate that there is an overall decrease by 13.3%. On the other hand, it is very encouraging to note that there are increases in reported cases as members of the public have been made aware of the importance of reporting and bringing the perpetrators to justice. Madam Speaker, just allow me to go through some of these figures. The offences against the lawful authority in 2014, it was 265, 2015, 257, in 2016, 336, increase of 27%. Offences against public morality, 2014, 4,415, 2015, 2,714, 2016, 1,696, a reduction of 61%. And the offences against person, which includes murder and manslaughter, in 2014, 3,061, 2015, 4,880, 2016, 5,360, increase of 75%. Offences against property, 2014, 8,622, 2015, 11,340, 2016, 10,719, a decrease of 24%. And other offences against the crime decree, which includes drugs, Madam Speaker, in 2014, 1,273, 2015, 1,628, 2016, 1,880, an increase of 48%. So overall, Madam Speaker, a reduction of 13.3% over the years of 2014 to 2016. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you. Honourable Maraj.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, my supplementary question to Minister would be, what initiative have been undertaken by Fiji Police Force that contributed to decrease in crime? Thank you.
Thank you, Honourable Minister.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. The key initiatives implemented by the Fiji Police Force to reduce crime included the followings. One, push forward of manpower to the front lines through ongoing recruits and training of officers. Secondly, the strengthening of special task forces in all divisions. Third, strengthening of Nduabata community policing. And that's targeting women and children. And fourth, collaboration with relevant stakeholders, to name a few. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you, and I give the floor to the Honourable Nwekwe.
The police annual report for 2015 states increases in rape and attempted rape by 38 cases, murder by 6 cases, robbery by 67 cases, burglary 554 cases, and other offences 96. Could the Honourable Minister confirm to this House whether really there is a decrease or there is an increase? Because I'm reading it differently here. This is the figures for 2015.
Thank you, Honourable Minister.
And this is taken from the annual report.
Madam Speaker, as I mentioned, the statistic is very clear. In 2014, reference to the rape and attempted rape was 246. 2015, 284. And 2016, 328. So there was an increase of 33%, and that's what I said.
Increase.
Increase.
Thank you. And now give the floor to Honourable Mariko.
First, in addressing the type of offences. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you, Honourable Minister.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. You may note from my earlier response that there are increases in offences against the persons by 75% and other offences against the crime by 48%. These offences range from attempted murder, manslaughter, serious to common assault, forgery, to drugs. And let me take, for example, offences related to drugs. Madam Speaker, we agree that there has been significant growth in the unlawful handling of drugs. Drug trafficking and other commodities are generally characterized by high levels of organization and the presence of strong criminal groups and networks. In addressing such challenges, I support the sentiments echoed by the Commissioner of Police that we can overcome these challenges if we work together as responsible citizens to fight this crime. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you.